It's becoming a very, very, very tough time in the heart of many people today, all over the world, both young and old. Not knowing how to answer the question, does God have a plan for me? And I know that it's a tall order in the life of many people today. And this was the case with God's people. I can imagine when they were in Babylon. They must have been in Babylon, only God knows, for years. And the promises before them, but the manifestation looks far from being far-fetched. Maybe that's where you are. But I want to encourage you from God's word, because there are those who waited on God's promises and they saw it come to pass. And there are those who couldn't wait. They not only got frustrated, sad to say, some even took their life. But that will never be your case. Let me encourage you from God's promise, from Jeremiah 29:11. God said to his people, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you, not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future." It's satanic strategy to push us to a corner wherein we feel and we think there's no future, there's no plan, there's no need living. But that's the trick of the devil. But God's word makes it very clear, and I believe it's coming clearer to you and I more than ever before, that he has a plan, and that plan is a good plan, and that plan is not of evil, and that plan is to give you a future and to give you hope. Now, all the system of this world does is take, 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 but God gives, and he still wants to give. So no matter where you are with regards to, I've waited for so long for my child, maybe you've been married for years and you've been expected to have a baby, and it seems as though, for how long do we have to wait? Or maybe as a spinster or as a bachelor, you've waited for the right man or the right woman, it seems, I can't still see him or her. I believe in my heart that when you allow the truth of God's promise to be resonate in your heart, it strengthens your faith to receive, because faith in our heart is not only for receiving, it's for living. And nothing brings faith like the word of God. I strongly believe that when this word came to God's people, it puts strength into their heart. It brought vigor and vitality within their system, and they could raise their head up and face the future ahead of them. Because I know in my heart that for you, you are much closer than where you began. And all it takes, just like Job said, "I know that my Redeemer liveth," that you will come to a place of knowing that God has a plan for you. And as you come to know that God has a plan for you, now begin to picture that plan and speak that plan. Don't speak doom, don't speak gloom, don't speak hopelessness, don't speak nothing but the word of God. Because forever, O Lord, your word is settled. So today, I want you to be encouraged. Rise up within you and let God, by the power of his Holy Spirit, begins to help you erase from your mind pictures of gloom and pictures of doom, and begin to see pictures of beauty and pictures of glory. Because as you think in your heart, so you are. So think nothing but the word that says, "I have a plan, and it's a good plan, and that plan is not to harm you, and that plan is to give you a future and to give you a hope. This will come to pass, and you will yet testify." In Jesus' name.
We trust that you have been blessed by this encouraging word. Please feel free to connect with us via our social media platforms and share this clip with your friends. You are most welcome to fellowship with us at Grace Outreach, the Friendly Church. Remember, it's a new day in your life, and Jesus Christ is Lord. We look forward to seeing you.